Well, she shot to stardom as a reality TV star. Erin Barnett was even brave enough to enter the I'm a Celebrity jungle, and now she can add author to her resume with the release of her brand new and very personal book, ENDO UNFILTERED. And Erin joins us now from Melbourne. It's great to see you, Erin. Thanks for being with us. You've been so real and so open with your own battle with endometriosis over the years. You've spoken about how you've had more than 15 surgeries. So can you talk us through what it was like to first get that diagnosis? Because you were so young, 26, and you've already had that many surgeries.
I know. Well, thank you guys so much for having me on this morning. I'm really, really excited. I've had, it'll be 17 surgeries soon, all up. It's extremely, it's challenging getting diagnosed with endometriosis at such a young age, but it did take a few years for me to get diagnosed with endometriosis. At the start, it was PCOS, but I'm just really excited to be on here and talk about my new book and raise more awareness about endometriosis.
Yeah, it really is great. Erin, for those who don't know what endometriosis is, what is it and what is it like to have it?
Okay, so endometriosis is where the tissue similar to the lining that's found in our uterus grows everywhere else in our body. It's called the endometrium, and it's what we shed when we have our period each month, but instead there's nowhere else for it to go in because it's everywhere else in our body, so it just grows stronger and more aggressive, and it can become super debilitating. Living with it is awful because, say, right now you think I look fine, but I could be in a lot of pain, so it's extremely misleading because you can't see us in pain. If it was on the outside, I think people would be more aware of just how painful this condition could be.
Yeah, and it's more than just a heavy period, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. And there's no such thing as a bad period that we found out. We always grew up thinking bad periods was normal, but apparently that's the sign that something could be wrong.
I was stunned to read that 830,000 Australian women will experience endometriosis at some point. It's something like 11% of women in Australia. And the diagnosis is often slowed down because doctors simply don't believe them. It takes about 6.5 years on average to be diagnosed.
Yeah.
Had you had that experience? Were you told that, no, it's in your head? Did you struggle to get that diagnosis?
I actually did struggle to be diagnosed with endometriosis. PCOS, I was diagnosed at a young age, and they used to tell my mum that I had something that looked like suspected endometriosis, but not to worry, she's too young. And it was only a couple of years ago that I found out that I actually did have it because I had a gynaecologist take me seriously to take a biopsy while I had keyhole surgery. So I couldn't imagine how frustrating it would be to be a bit older, wanting children, and finding out you've had endometriosis and you've had all the signs and symptoms and no doctor would take you seriously.
Yeah, and you've had one of your ovaries removed. How will that impact your fertility? And is that something that you worry about at your age?
So I actually got diagnosed with adenomyosis as well just in December, which is where endometriosis grows inside the uterus wall. And to fix it, you do have to get a... Well, not fix it, but to get rid of it, you do have to get a hysterectomy. So I've been told at such a young age that I would struggle to have a child, and as I've gotten older, it's more likely not going to happen because I can't do IVF due to it overstimulating my ovaries and I grow cysts at such a strong rate. So I'm not really that bothered about it, I think, because if you've been through all the stuff that I've been through at 14 to 26, I'm almost 27, that is the last thing on your mind. I'm actually, like, begging for a hysterectomy just so I can be pain-free. A hysterectomy is not a cure, but without ovaries, I can't get ovarian cysts, so it's just kind of common sense to me.
Oh, wow. Poor thing, yeah. Erin, you've decided to share your story by writing a book. What was the driver behind that decision? I mean, it must have been very challenging to live through all your experiences again.
Yes, actually, it was super surprising, and it was actually very hard for my mum as well because I had to get her to go through all the old paperwork to try and get exactly how many surgeries I've had. But it was so weird writing it all down. But the drive behind the book was because I wish I had something like this when I was younger. Because when you go to the doctors with your parents, the doctors talk to the parents. They don't really talk to you, even though they're diagnosing you. So I want there to be a book out there that's really easy to read, super educational, and it feels like you've got a friend there next to you going through the same stuff.
Do you feel as though this topic is a bit taboo?
Yeah, absolutely. I think anytime you mention the word periods.
Women's problems.
Everyone just goes, ooh.
Yeah.
Yes, women's problems. People just, like, don't want to hear about it or don't want to talk about it. So I feel like we have to make people a bit uncomfortable to make this subject more comfortable to talk about.
Yeah. You're very comfy at the moment with your beautiful partner, Mick. You're all loved up. How's all that going?
Yes, it's going really well. I'm not sure. I think last time I spoke to you, we only had 2 dash hounds. Now he actually got me a dash hound for my birthday last year. So we've added an extra dog to the family.
Oh, very, very sweet. Any wedding bells in the future? Have you discussed that yet?
I discuss it with him all the time. So hopefully soon, just keep an eye out because as soon as he does, I'll be posting it everywhere.
There we go.
We won't miss it. Erin's book, ENDO UNFILTERED, is available now. Make sure you grab it. Erin, congrats on the book. And thank you so much for chatting with us today.
Thank you, guys. Bye.